When designing web elements, it's crucial to consider how they will appear under different layout conditions. Understanding how elements behave when they break across lines can be tricky, especially when it comes to their decorations like borders, backgrounds, and shadows. I once encountered a design challenge where the elements looked great on a single line but became messy when they were wrapped. What if there was a way to control how these elements behave? In this video, we are diving into a lesser-known CSS property that helps maintain a consistent look, even when elements wrap across multiple lines. But before we get started, make sure to hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell to stay updated on our upcoming tutorials. Let's dive in. We are starting with a simple HTML page that contains a header block, along with some basic heading and paragraph elements. Nothing too fancy, just the usual content you would find on most web pages. Our style sheet is also set up with some standard CSS rules to handle the page layout. And here's what the bare bones page looks like. Now let's first begin with the H2 tag to understand the problem we are addressing today and how we can fix it with just a single line of CSS. Suppose we have the following styles for our H2 element, including font size, weight, and text transform. We also want to apply a background along with some padding and a border. Since heading tags are block-level elements, the box decoration properties cover the entire block. However, our design specifications call for a different look and feel. We don't want to style the block as a single unit. Instead, we want to treat each line as a separate entity. The first thing we might consider is converting it into an inline element so that each line can be visualized separately. But that brings up another issue, the broken styles. Before moving forward, let's first understand the problem. When an element is broken into multiple fragments, its decoration styles follow suit. For example, if a heading is split across multiple lines, like in this case, by default, its decoration styles, such as border, padding, and background, will also be divided, creating a potentially uneven appearance. If you take a closer look, you will notice that the left border and left padding appear only at the beginning of the first fragment. Similarly, the right border and right padding are only displayed at the end of the last fragment. There is no consistency in the overall appearance of the element. We can fix this with the help of the box decoration break CSS property. According to the documentation, the box decoration break property specifies how different fragments of an element should be rendered when broken across multiple lines, columns, or pages. In simple terms, it lets us control how box decorations are drawn across the fragments of a broken element. An element can break into fragments at the end of a line, across columns, or at page breaks. This property can take one of two values: slice, which is the default behavior, or clone. By default, box decorations apply to the element as a whole and break at the edges of the fragments. To maintain browser compatibility, we need to use the WebKit vendor prefix along with the standard syntax. When specified as clone, decorations apply to each fragment as if they were unbroken, individual elements. Borders wrap the four edges of each fragment, and backgrounds are redrawn in full. Let's take a step back, revert to the default behavior, and replace the plain background with a linear gradient of two colors. As expected, the first color of the gradient starts at the beginning of the first fragment, while the last color appears at the end of the last fragment. As soon as we apply the box decoration break, we gain full control over how an element's decorations behave when it's split across multiple lines. Remember, this property only affects elements that are broken into multiple fragments. Moving forward, let's see how it behaves when we try to style a specific portion of a paragraph. First, we will use the span tag for selection within the paragraph, and then in the CSS, we will apply similar decorations like a border, border radius, and the same background image. As you can see, the decoration properties are applied to the span element as a whole. We can fix this by simply using our magic wand, the box decoration break property. Now let's take a step forward and see how it affects animations. First, we will add a class to the paragraph and a span within it. Then in the style sheet, we will make a slight update to the existing selector and start a new CSS block. This is just to avoid any conflicts between styles. Next, we will apply similar padding and background. But this time, We will also use the background size property to hide it initially. What we are doing is setting the horizontal size of the background to 0% while keeping the height at a full 100%. After that, we will use the hover pseudo class to reset the background to its full 100% width and height. Then setting the transition property along with the background repeat to no repeat creates a unique text highlighting effect. And now, if we use the box decoration break, it also affects the animation. Previously, the effect ran as a single unit from the beginning of the element to the end. With this property applied, each fragment has its own transitioning effect. Let's take another look. Notice the difference? A single animation versus separate animations running simultaneously. Finally, let's go through our last example of the day. This time, we will work with our page title. Starting with some presentational styles, we add our usual padding and background image. Then converting it to an inline element brings us to this default behavior of box decoration. Now, if we set the background size to 100% of the width and 30% of the height, and then set background repeat to no repeat along with background position to 0 on the x-axis and 90% on the y-axis, we achieve this cool effect of vertically positioned background that stretches across the entire width of each line segment. However, you might have noticed some issues with the decoration. For instance, there is no left padding on the second fragment, and the gradient is spread as a single unit. The box decoration break can be a lifesaver in this situation. It provides granular control over the behavior, allowing us to create visually harmonious and professional designs. By mastering this property, you can ensure that your elements look polished and consistent, regardless of screen size or layout complexity. That wraps up our exploration of the box decoration break. I hope you now have a clear understanding of how it can help you manage box decorations across fragmented elements and enhance your designs. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more tips and tricks. Drop a comment below if you have any questions or want to share your experiences. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.